you close your eyes. Does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes.
So today's day zero, and we've currently just finished having our last final dinner before we embark on our little adventure. Our route tomorrow involves climbing and walking across the top of a mountain. And I'm looking forward to it because the weather's good. And I think it'll be quite a bit of fun.
It's the first day, some beautiful porridge. We're just cooking up, finishing up, gonna pack up our tents and head off.
Day one I thought was quite a nice journey. There were a few little tough bits, but we all kind of got through and we all made it to the end.
It was an accomplishment, I guess, with all the hard work previously, all the training into end of day one. Yeah, it was alright.
Day one was the hardest day we've ever had. Lots of incline, and it was over a short distance, so it was a killer.
After that first leg of the journey, there's a little section where we actually climbed through the top of a mountain and through two intersections. That was really nice, kind of just being able to see it all. And also there's a section where we were just walking on the top of a ridge and we could see everywhere, both sides.
Get into camp, like we could finally relax and just chill out for once.
I guess being on top of the mountain and just seeing the view, yeah, the view was really, really good.
There was this incline that was practically vertical, and trying to get up just hurt my legs.
How many bugs there were at our campsite, and I'm covered in bug bites now.
It was stopping too much. I quite like just, you know, walking and going, and that kind of slowed me down and got me a bit more tired.
Day two, I think we just did the first leg, so, and we're ahead of schedule now. So I think we better. It was pretty difficult, but the rest of it should be okay.
Our longest day, but it should be okay since we're just walking on top of a mountain. I think the hardest bit will be having to climb that mountain.
So far so good. That walk there was not nice. Always the start is not nice, but I think the rest of the day is going to be good.
Day two was quite good. We were ahead of schedule for just about the whole day, so we were able to take it nice and easy and take lots of breaks throughout. So I'd say it's like got to be one of the best days we've ever done.
Day two was definitely better than day one. It was much longer than day one. We did, a 21.4 kilometer walk this day. But it was more chilled because we were walking up mountains. We were walking like on the top of the mountain, so it was all right.
It's pretty good. Better than day one, definitely. I'm less tired. I have no blisters this day. And yeah, the climb was pretty good.
Arriving into camp, just being able to drop all the weight off our shoulders and actually relax. But it was quite a nice atmosphere in camp. There was two other groups, we were able to just chat to them.
We got to our checkpoint about an hour early, so it was pretty chilled up there. I got creative with my sandwich. What did I get? I had like spicy mackerel and like tomato sauce, and I put my like my bread and I made a wrap and everything. It was and I had barbecue sauce from McDonald's barbecue sauce. Yeah, that was pretty nice. Really nice actually.
When we got to our high point, which was like 6:32 I think, and yeah, we could see other mountains and see a sea and rest wobbler.
In the morning we were kind of rushed, but we were early anyway, when we got back to camp there were so many flies, they were just kept landing on our faces, landing on our insect repellent wouldn't work.
Honestly, I think the worst point of the day is right now, because we're surrounded by these bugs. They're like leeches and they're just swarming us.
Day three looks good. Looking at yesterday, we should be able to do this in a breeze, really. There's hardly any climb and there is hardly much distance, really. I mean, maybe it would be nav, but we can get around that.
Today looks all right, doesn't look too bad. It's a short day, so it should be all right. Like, we should do it quickly. I don't think there should be any trouble with us. My knee might mess up, but I think we can get through that.
I'm actually looking forward to day three. It's a shorter distance. I think it's around 18 km. And the incline, I think we're going to have to climb about 400 meters. So that's nothing compared to day two and day one. so it should be an easy day.
Today, I think it was probably the worst day out of all of them. The weather was terrible. It began to rain. I think we all wished for rain, but we wished for like spitting, as in light rain, and not the mushing, the rain that will turn the mud wet. I remember going, I think nearly just over ankle deep in mud, and my socks were soaked. It was horrid.
It was alright still. The walk wasn't too bad, but the weather just wasn't nice.
Day 3, probably one of my most favourite days so far. Yeah, surprisingly. I liked the fact that previous experiences, such as like going to the New Forest where it was quite marshy, like it was quite similar to the experience we had today.
I think the best part was coming here, and when we got to the campsite, like everyone pigged out.
Would be the views. Kind of when we did get up to the top and kind of the mist did clear, you could see for miles. And there was also a nice bit right at the end where you could see the dam. And to be honest, it did look like we were still in Canada or somewhere like that. Just a completely different atmosphere.
I guess coming to this campsite, finally was able to take a shower. So yeah, pretty happy about that.
Worst thing for me is when it started raining. Not just when it's raining, it's more when we had to walk through long grass and suddenly higher up along your legs were getting wetter because of all the grass kind of rubbing against your legs. And it just didn't feel that nice. It was quite uncomfortable. And especially when you're like midway through DofE and then you're just like, oh, do I actually want to complete this anymore? But you just gotta kind of keep pushing yourself even more.
Oh, my socks. Oh, they're kind of bad.
Because it was raining quite a bit today, there was quite a lot of marsh around and boots. We're not waterproof, even though they were advertised as waterproof, so. Well, I guess the lesson is by waterproof sock.
Last day, last leg, just gonna push it. And when we get the little pass at the end, Prasad's gonna treat us to fish and chips, so I'm excited.
Oh, day 4. Well, we're up nice and early for day 4. Kind of all the other days it's been 8 o'clock start, but for this one we're gonna leave camp at 6. So we're pushing it well out of the boat to try and get back to the finish line at the reservoir as early as possible so we can kind of get on that first train home, because otherwise we're gonna be back really late and we just wanna relax, get home and just chill out.
So happy. We plan on walking to our assessor with our caps, all of us with our own caps. They look like golf hats, but still, it's pretty cool. We're gonna sing, we're gonna play Just Hold On, We're Going Home. Yes, this is the victory look that you need when you know you're gonna get gold. I'm pretty confident about getting gold tomorrow. Tomorrow's route is pretty easy, just a bit shorter than today by 100 meters. It should be fun. I can't wait to get home in my own bed, have a warm shower. That's how you'll feel.
Yay, there we go. Well done, guys. That is brilliant. That is fantastic. Well, well done. Yay, fantastic.
I see, I want your high love.
take four was amazing. Kind of up at 4:30, and then kind of gone from camp about six. And it was basically straight walking, not continuously, with hardly any breaks. But no, it was a good day overall.
Day four was, in my opinion, the best day because we were completely on it. We smashed it. We were ahead of schedule by at least an hour and a half, and it was a breeze.
Day four is just like how I predicted it yesterday. It was really fun. We somehow woke up at 4:30 and made it really quick to our final destination.
Finally coming to the finish line, walking that long bridge and knowing that we've done a good job.
Yeah, definitely the fish and chips. It was that reward, that facade. We've been begging for it since the first day. I think it was just that summed up the whole week past.
Best part of day four. It's kind of crossing that finish line at the end and kind of meeting Andy and him saying that we've got the DofE Gold and we've actually completed the expedition and passed. Just kind of felt amazing to actually feel like we're the first people at BDA to actually achieve the DofE Gold award.
There was a decline going downwards with really, really sharp and slippery rocks, quite dangerous.
Worst thing had to be the 4:30 start. Although we kind of all got up, it was a sluggish beginning for all of us and quite painful as well.
The weather and the inclines, so we weren't great, but we're used to them now, so
it wasn't bad. Watching Poussard come towards us and basically congratulating us.
One night I couldn't sleep, so I stayed up and watched the stars and I actually saw the Milky Way for my third time seeing the Milky Way for a while, so it's really good.
First day we arrived, like, it didn't feel like it was setting, but it was like one of the best moments of the whole trip, I think.
The most memorable moment of the trip for me is going to be the views, kind of when we're at the top of the mountains. It was kind of a stunning kind of atmosphere when you got right at the top, and I don't think I'll forget that for a long time.
It was the first day, and Andy, our examiner, had borrowed us a frisbee. And I must have thrown a frisbee, and Anton started like running for the frisbee, and he tripped over, and he fell. And the worst thing was, he still tried to catch a frisbee while he was falling. It was just too funny.
Most memorable moment for me was when we jumped over the fence into the field on our second night, I think it was, and we tried to watch the sunset. We didn't get to see it properly, but it was still pretty nice to see the sky.
Bring tortillas and bring squeezy cheese.
Bring sardines.
Bring as many socks as you can. Like, not just one for each day, like maybe two, maybe three for each day, just so that you can keep your feet from getting sore or getting any blisters. Oh, and compete patches.
Make your bag as light as possible and make sure you fully adjust it when you begin. If you don't, you will feel the pain going throughout.
And make sure they have their waterproofs. And definitely a change of socks. Like, that's definitely needed because my feet are soaked.
Waterproof socks, lifesavers. My feet were bone dry the whole time, everybody else was soaked.